Hi everyone, Conrad here with Conrad's Corner and your midweek 1 minute entertainment review. Today we're going to focus in on one production number, and that number is Lincoln, Divided We Stand. Production companies, Glass Entertainment Group, distributed by CNN. This series is narrated by Sterling K. Brown, who many folks will know from today's This Is Us TV series. All right, very unique show because we're only going to focus in on one production number. What's interesting, what's many things that are interesting about this production is that there are some excellent experts who we're going to hear information from. There are some terrific reenactments which really put you right there in the middle of the action. There are some hard to look at photos from war period. And did you know that Conan O'Brien, comedian, TV host, is an Abraham Lincoln collector? Now you do. And we're going to hear from him in just a few moments. We all know that we just went through a very busy election period, and we heard a lot of quotes from Lincoln. We're going to start off with one of those quotes.
We are not enemies, but friends. We must not be enemies. Though passion may have strained, it must not break our bonds of affection.
The title, Divided We Stand, comes from an 1858 speech Lincoln was given as he ran for U.S. Senate against Stephen A. Douglas. Did you know that Lincoln was a storyteller and a jokester? Listen to this story.
He was riding along, and a woman is riding the other way and stops him.
She aimed a rifle at him, and he said, "Madam, why are you pointing that gun at me?"
And you can see just Lincoln, like Buster Keaton or any great, just staring.
And she said, "Because I always resolved that if I ever met a man who was uglier than I am, I would shoot him." And he looked at her and he said, "Madam, if I am really uglier than you, then fire away."
Did you know that Lincoln was a storyteller and a jokester? I didn't know that. Something new to me. Maybe we were taught that in school, and I was milk monitor maybe during that time, and I was out busy delivering milk to my fellow classmates. Hey, it's interesting information regardless. You learn a lot in this film. Let me tell you, in this series, I'm not a type of person who watches TV, watches a movie, and wants to learn things. Right? I've learned enough. Not really, but you know, I want to be entertained. You're going to be entertained here, and you're also going to learn. And here are some interesting facts. Listen to this. Lincoln gave a speech at one time that said he was thinking about giving the opportunity for slaves to vote. John Wilkes Booth, who of course we all know later on assassinated Lincoln, was at that speech. And he told people around him he was going to assassinate him. And the evening of his assassination, Lincoln told his bodyguard that he had a dream that he thought he was going to be assassinated. I didn't know that. I learned that in this series. And here's something interesting also. We all know that Lincoln lived in a log cabin. That all sounds so interesting. You have to remember, though, this was rough and tough times. No electricity, no running water. He had to build a fire for heat. When he was young, the age 9, Lincoln's mother passed away, and his father left him and his kid sister in the log cabin to fend for themselves for a winter while his father went out to find a bride. I had no idea that happened. And also, you know, they say that a good politician is a politician who has compassion. Listen to the type of grief that Lincoln experienced in his lifetime. Lincoln's grandfather was killed while out farming with his sons by Native Americans. Remember, this was the West. His mother died when he was 9. His sister Sarah died at childbirth with their baby, with her baby. His future partner Anne Rutledge died. His second son died of tuberculosis. His third son died at the age 11. Right? And pretty interesting, all that tragedy in his life. And here's something I didn't know about also. Did you know that the Lincoln legacy only recently ended in 1985 with the passing of his great-grandson, Robert Todd Lincoln? Hey, things you can learn when watching TV and being entertained. There you have it. I'm Conrad. This is Conrad's Corner with your midweek 1 minute entertainment review. Hey, it's worth watching. It's on CNN, and also you can find it on YouTube, and I give it a big yes. Enjoy.